I ain't afraid no ghost. What's good, Power Director peeps? Today, I'm gonna show you how to do the ghost effect using Power Director 17. If you've been wondering how to do this effect, I want you to put hashtag ghouls are for fools in the comment section below. Here we are in Power Director 17. The ghost effect is a great special effect that can be used in your videos to amaze your viewers. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a ghost effect for your videos. Let's scare the bejesus out of somebody. You'll need to use a tripod to record three clips. Don't move the camera when you're recording, after, in between takes, nothing. Make sure that it is in the exact same position for each one of your three clips. If the camera moves, this effect's going to be real boo-boo-y. Real boo-boo-y. Now, one clip is the person getting up. That clip needs to be on track three. It will be the ghost that comes out of the person that's lying down. The second clip is the person lying down. That clip needs to be on track two. It will be the person that disappears out of the scene after the ghost rises out of her. And the third clip is a scene with no one in it, and it's on track one. This serves as the background that's going to remain after all the ghosts are out of the scene. On track three, what you want to do is move that clip to a position where you want the person to be rising out of the person that's laying down. I already have my clip in the right position, so I'm not going to move it anywhere. After you get it in that position, you want to double left click on it to open up the PIP designer. And you want to go ahead and go down to the opacity setting, and you want to change the opacity to 10%. This is going to make the person who's rising out of the person laying down more opaque and make it seem like it's a ghost that's coming out of them. So if you click on play at this point, you'll see that this is going to create a ghost coming out of the person laying down. Voila. All right, so that's pretty easy. Now, I want you to remember, you can use whatever opacity percentage that you want, but the higher the opacity is, the more transparent all of the tracks underneath will be. So in my opinion, it's better to use a lower opacity than using a higher one. Now, once you get that done, you want to click on OK. And then you want this clip to fade in and out. You don't want it to be jarring. So what you want to do is you want to go to the transition room, and you can go to favorites or general or whatever, and use the fade transition. You want to drag this to the beginning of the clip on track three, and then you also want to drag another one to the end of the clip on track three, and now it will be more pleasing, and when it comes on the screen, it won't be as jarring. So let's play this back. Looks really good. Now you want to make the person lying down disappear. But before you do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to Power Director University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. And if you subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial. So you want to move your playhead to a position where you want the person laying down to start to fade off the screen. I think that's pretty good right there. And once you get your playhead to the right position, you want to double left click on the clip on track two to open up the PIP designer. And you'll see that the playhead is at that same position that it was on the timeline. And here you want to enable the opacity keyframe by clicking on this little diamond. And then you want to go ahead and move your playhead to a position where you want the individual to be gone off the screen. And that's pretty good there. And at this point, you want to change the opacity down to zero and hit enter. And so what will happen now is this
keyframe here is the establishing start of the fade off the screen. So everything before that, the person laying down is going to be visible. And once the playhead hits this keyframe, it's going to start to fade all the way down to zero. And when it gets to zero, the individual will disappear off the screen for the last part of this. So if I move my playhead here and press play, you'll see the individuals on the screen, and then all of a sudden they disappear and they go off the screen. Now the reason why there's still that background is because we have that third clip on track one, which is just the blank background. It's a blank slate with no one in it. And so when we make this clip on this track disappear, we can still see the background because we have that other clip on track one. Now you can go ahead and click on okay. And if we play the whole thing back, then you should be able to see a ghoulish effect. And that's how you make the ghost effect using PowerDirector 17. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 17 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. See you again soon.